Hello and welcome to this edition of Computer Lectures. We'll continue our Computer Lectures with Chapter 4, which is Share Capital and Debentures. Today, in this lecture, we will be focusing on Section 48, which speaks about variation of shareholders' rights. If the company wants to make any variation in such shareholders' rights, what is the procedure which is given in Section 48? So, without wasting any time, let's get to Section 48. I'm your host and teacher, Santosh Baliga. First of all, Section 48 speaks about variation of shareholders' rights. So shareholders' rights are such rights which are already given in the terms and conditions of the issue itself. Whenever the company comes up with an issue of share capital and issues any equity shares for that particular class, the company would have already provided the terms and conditions. And now, if it is necessary for the company, there might be circumstances which makes it necessary for the company to amend. Amend means change the rights attached to such one or more classes of shares. Then the Section 48 has given some provisions with regards to procedure of the same. Okay, this is clear, introduction is clear. So for amending the rights of shareholders is known as variation of rights. So you understood what is variation of rights? Variation of rights means changes which is to be made in the rights of shareholders or amending the rights of shareholders. Okay, I hope this much is clear. So with this base, we'll move ahead to the procedure. So what is the procedure? What is the procedure for variation of rights of a class of shareholders? This is what is given in Section 48. Okay, so the rights of a class of shareholders may be varied by the company, that is changed by the company, only with the consent in writing of holders of not less than three fourths means 75% of issued shares of that particular class. So it is in writing of holders of not less than three fourths of issued shares of that particular class. So I hope this is clear. Okay. Or one is you can get the consent in writing, or you can also call for a general meeting or separate meeting of such class of equity shareholders and pass a special resolution. In this case, you will not have to have consent in writing, but in the special resolution, by way of poll, by way of voting, you will pass the resolution. Okay. So it is either consent in writing or a special resolution passed will be required. Okay, this part is clear, this condition is clear. Now, this can happen only basic conditions have to be fulfilled. First, the provision of the variation, the provision of such variation shall be given in the memorandum or articles of association of the company. So memorandum or articles of association shall be giving the right to the company to change the variation. Then only the above procedure can be followed. Or in absence of such provision, if such provision is not there in the memorandum or articles of the company, then such variation is not prohibited by the terms of issue of shares of that particular class. So when the shares are issued at that point of time, such a variation shall not be specifically prohibited by the terms of such issue. So this is the major framework under which you can vary the rights of the shareholders of a particular class. Now there are very important points also. First important point is the variation of rights of one class of shareholders. If I'm going to vary the rights or change the rights of one class of shareholders, and if it affects the rights of any other class of shareholders, then in that case, consent of three-fourths of such other class of shareholders will also need to be obtained. So in this case, we will require consent of such class plus consent of other class which is affected from such variation. Okay, so this point is clear. Next point is if more than 10%, see, what is the requirement? Requirement is 75% or 3/4 shall give consent. 75% or 3/4 shall give consent. But if there are more than 10%, more than 10% of such issued class of shareholders who did not consent, then there is a remedy which is provided to them. They can go and apply to NCLT, that is tribunal. So for making the application to a tribunal against such an variation, you would require at least 10% of issued class of such shareholders consent, and then only you can make the, then only you will have the eligibility to make the application to NCLT to review such an order, to review such an variation that has been made by the company. And till such time that the NCLT or tribunal does not come up with an confirmation of such a variation, the variation which shall be put on hold and shall be stayed by the NCLT itself. Okay, this point is clear. So see, if more than 10% of issued class of shareholders did not consent to such variation, then remedy is provided that they can apply to the NCLT, and such application shall be made within 21 days of the consent or resolution is passed. Within 21 days of the consent is received or the resolution is passed by the company in a separate meeting, within 21 days, such 10%, at least 10% of that particular class of shareholders who are not consenting to such a variation can make an application to NCLT to have the variation cancelled. What will be the effect of such an application? Effect will be that variation shall not have effect unless and until the NCLT confirms it. Unless and until the NCLT confirms it. So this point is clear. Now NCLT will go into the merits of this particular application, and a decision will be given by the tribunal, and such decision shall be binding on all the shareholders, including the dissenting shareholders. Such order of tribunal shall be filed by the company within 30 days with the ROC. So you are able to understand the flow of this particular thing. See, let me summarize once again this point. The variation of rights, if it is made to one class of shareholders and it is affecting any other class of shareholders, then consent of such other class of shareholders of 3/4 shall also be obtained. First point is clear. Second point, if 10% or more of such class of shareholders are not accepting such a variation, then they can, as a remedy, apply to NCLT, that is a tribunal, to have such variation cancelled. And such an application shall be made within 21 days of such resolution or consent is obtained. And NCLT shall go into the merits of such application and pass an order or decision. Such decision shall be binding on all the members, all the shareholders of that particular class. And the company, on receipt of such order by the tribunal, shall file the order within 30 days with the ROC. So now it is clear. Now, after this thing, if the company makes any default, then there will be penalty, or you can also say punishment. For the company, the punishment will be a fine of not less than 25,000 rupees, and it can extend up to 5 lakh rupees. 25,000 rupees, and it can extend to 5 lakh rupees. For every officer in default, who is involved, will face an imprisonment of up to 6 months, or a fine of minimum 25,000, which may extend up to 5 lakh rupees, or even there is a provision for both imprisonment plus fine. So I hope this particular section 48 is clear to you now, and you have understood this section. If you have understood this section, then please press the like button and share this video to maximum of your friends and your groups. And if you have not yet subscribed to this channel, please subscribe to this channel. It adds to motivation for me to add or upload many more videos of company law. Thanks a lot.